Good morning students, I am back with a new video. In my previous video, we were doing question chapter from English grammar book. Today, we will do exercises based on it. Before starting my class, first we will recall what we have done in our previous class. In our previous class, I have told you what is question. Hope you remember. Okay, I will tell you. When we arrange a group of words in such a way that it asks about something, such set of words is called questions. They can be in a form of yes or no questions, or they can be in a form of WH questions. Okay class, now let's start doing our exercises. Now class, first we will do our homework part, which I have given you in my previous video. Then we will do other exercises. The question was, fill in the blanks choosing correct words from the bracket. So you have to choose one word from the bracket. The first one is dash you speak English. So here R will not come. Here do will come. Do you speak English? See the second. Dash they coming for dinner. Here R. Are they coming for dinner? Third, is it raining? Fourth, may I come in? Fifth, has she finished her lunch? Sixth, did Miss Sharma tell them a story? Seventh, will it rain tomorrow? Eighth, is Bella ill today? Ninth, may I use your computer? Tenth, will you have tea or coffee? Hope you have done your homework. If you have not done, then do it now. You can pause the video and start doing, or you can take a screenshot of this page. Now moving to other exercise. Question is, change the following sentences into questions. You have to change the sentences in a form of question. So see the first one. He has a sister called Rita. So you have to change it in a form of question. So you will change like this. Does he have a sister called Rita with a question mark? Now see the second. Old people don't like noise. So you will write like this. Do old people like noise with a question mark? See the third one. They could not stop laughing. So you will write like this. Could they stop laughing with a question mark? See, if you are changing in a form of a question, so the meaning of a sentence is not changing. Meaning will be same, but you have to change the sentence in a question form. Now see the fourth one. The rice was cooked properly. So you will change like this. Was the rice cooked properly? Fifth, I saw the helicopter. Did you see the helicopter? Here I is changed to you. Now see the another exercise. In this, complete the following questions by using appropriate words given below. Here are few words. You have to use these words. Where, what, why, which, whose, whom, where, when, how, who. So you have to use these words to fill these sentences. The first one. Dash is he saying. So what will come? What. Here where will not come. Where is he saying? Why is he saying? Here what will come? What is he saying? Now see the second. Dash old are you? So here what will come? How old are you? Third, dash shall I put this bed? So you will write here where shall I put this bed. Fourth, dash are you? So you will write here who are you. You are asking question, who are you. Fifth, fifth dash dress do you prefer? So, which dress do you prefer? 6 dash is Sunuti crying? So, why is Sunuti crying? 7th dash is she. Where is she? 8th dash is going to invite to the party. Here what will come? Home. Home is she going to invite to the party. Then see the 9th. Dash do the schools open? When do the schools open? Dash book can I borrow? Whose book can I? Now the next exercise is fill in the blanks with appropriate question tags. So in previous video only I have told you what is question tags. Sometimes people finish what they are saying with a short questions to confirm if the person they are talking to agree with them or not. These short questions are called question tags. Now see the first one. Is a lovely weather? So isn't it? So what will come here? Isn't it? And you can see that it's a lovely weather. So this sentence is in a form of positive. This sentence is positive, but the tag is negative. The question tag is negative. In previous video only I have told you that when the sentence will be positive, the negative tag will be there. But when the sentence is negative, then the positive tag will be there. Now see the second. Nikki has short hairs, hasn't she? So Nikki has short hair. This is positive and it include with a negative tag. Now see the third. Rahul is a good runner, isn't he? So Rahul is a good runner. This is positive and it includes with a negative tag. Fourth, I am not too fat. So am I? So what is this? I am not too fat. This is positive or negative? This is negative, because not is there, na? I am not too fat. So this is negative sentence, but it have positive tag. Now see the fifth one. He likes drawing, doesn't he? So he likes drawing is a positive, but it is included with a negative tag. Now see the sixth. You would like a drink. So wouldn't you? So this is positive and it have a negative tag. Now see the seventh. I am your best friend. I am not. So here the sentence is positive, but it includes negative tag. Now see the 8th one. We can leave our bag here, can't we? So here we can leave our bag here. This is positive or negative? This is positive sentence, but it includes negative tag. So by this you can see that all the sentences which are positive, they will always have a negative tag. But when the sentence is negative, then they will have positive tag. Now in this exercise, arrange the following sets of jumbled words into interrogative sentences. So you have to arrange the jumbled words in a interrogative sentences. And what is interrogative sentences? Interrogative sentences are those sentences which ask questions and they will always have a question mark. So now see the first one. She come late, how did why? So you will arrange like this. Why did she come home late? See the second. Do they earn living there? How? So you will arrange like this. How do they earn their living? Third one. Nowadays Ramu is where? So you will arrange like this. Where is Ramu nowadays? Fourth. Reach when you home will? You will arrange like this. When will you reach home? Fifth, lesson should teach I him a. So you will arrange like this. Should I teach him a lesson with a question mark? All questions, all sentences will have a question mark because you are changing in a form of interrogative sentences. These all exercises are from your grammar book. If you have your grammar book, then do it there. But if you don't have your grammar book, then write each exercises in your grammar copy. Now see the sixth one. Help won't us they. So you have to rearrange it. Then you will get won't they help us. So now your homework for today is frame a question using each of the following words. The words are given below. You have to make a sentence in a form of question. So the words are where, why, how, isn't, can't, hasn't. So do your homework. And if you have any doubts regarding any topic or any chapter, for that you can comment below my video. And if you have missed any video, for that you can subscribe my channel. Then on my channel page you can find all the videos of your class and what I used to give you in homework, write in your grammar copy. And what I used to give literature homework, then write in your literature copy. Hope you all have written all the chapters question answers which we have done, that is chapter 1 Mr. Nobody, then second chapter was Tom Sawyer's Gang, third was Whistle Away, and the fourth was A School with a Difference. Now I will end my video. Till then, be safe and stay at your home.